all the diseases known to mankind. Who has heard of insulin resistance? Insulin resistance is also known as prediabetes. And we'll cover some numbers here in a minute. But here's basically how it works. You have a little diagram, but I'll try to draw it as we go. I'll just draw the one. So here is a cell. And the cell has a membrane, and out around here are sugar molecules. And we'll just draw them round for simplicity. So we have some sugar molecules out here, and the cell needs the sugar inside because nothing happens in the body until the energy is inside the cell. So now we need something called an insulin receptor. And here is the insulin receptor, and it looks like that, let's say. And then comes around, and I'll keep drawing colors here, then we have insulin, and we'll just draw that as a triangle. And insulin floats around, and then insulin makes its way and attaches to the receptor, and it causes a conformation change. So now this channel is available to process and transport glucose. So here comes the glucose molecule. Before it was just floating around, but now because of the insulin, it can get inside the cell. So inside the cell, we need to maintain a certain amount of glucose to create energy for the metabolic processes and the life of the cell. But we only need so much at a time, so that's why the fuel supply needs to be gradual. And that's why, again, the sugar is so devastating, because it's not gradual. It's an avalanche. Let me draw a few more of these. So there's a receptor, there's a receptor, there's a receptor, and there's a receptor. So in order to process and get a gradual supply of sugar, we need a certain amount of receptors, and we need a certain amount of insulin. So hypothetically speaking, for illustration purposes, this amount of receptors and this amount of insulin will provide that much sugar for the cell. And that will maintain the processes. Now, we have a bunch of Coca-Cola and donuts and junk food and syrup. And all of a sudden, we have five times as much sugar in the bloodstream. Here's all that sugar. And it's just banging on the door to get into the cell. And there's some insulin receptors that are attaching, and they're allowing the sugar to get into the cell. But with this much sugar around, pretty soon the cell is going to be saturated. And it's going to say, well, you know, hold off, guys. I don't need that much. So what's the cell going to do? We know the principle of use it or lose it, that the body will always only replenish the resources that it needs. And if there's this much sugar, the cell doesn't need this many receptors. So there's two steps. It's going to turn down its sensitivity. It's going to turn down its allowance. So it's going to say, for every insulin molecule, I'm only going to let in half as many sugar molecules. That's the first step of insulin resistance. The second step is that it's going to say, you know, with this much sugar, I don't need all these receptors. With this much sugar, I can get all the sugar I want inside the cell with half as many receptors. Because when it rains, it pours. So imagine that you had a cabin and you were living off the land and the only water that you had was rainwater. And so every time it rained, you had 100 buckets, and you would go put the buckets out and collect the rainwater, and you get that much water in each bucket, and then you collected all the buckets and you put them in, and you got 4 buckets worth of water, and you were good for a week. And then hopefully it rained again within the next week. What would happen if it was always raining? It was always pouring down. Would you still put out 100 buckets? Or would you just sit on the porch and stick a bucket out when you needed some? That's what the cell is doing. When it's raining, when it's too much, when it's an abundant availability, it's not going to make as many receptors. That's called down-regulation of receptors. And it's one of the most crucial principles in physiology, that your body will adapt to your environment. So diabetes is not a disease, it's an adaptation and nothing more. It's a physiological adaptation. And also what happens now, we still have all this sugar in the bloodstream. What did we say about too much blood sugar in the sugar in the bloodstream? We said it's an emergency. The brain will go into a coma. So now we have a challenging situation, because the brain needs to get the sugar out of the bloodstream, but the cells don't want it. So now the brain says to the pancreas, we need to get this out of here, make more insulin. Make a whole bunch of insulin. And if you make enough, you can cram all that into the cell and you can turn it all into fat. But in the long run, you're pushing the system so hard it's going to break. Because if the pancreas is always being made to produce more and more and more insulin, and the cell is becoming more and more insulin resistant, then you're pushing the system from two directions, and the system doesn't want to play like that. So eventually what happens is the pancreas burns out. And you have so much insulin resistance in the cells that the pancreas can't keep up making enough insulin. And that's the end stage of insulin resistance and pre-diabetes. And if you push this just a little bit further, now the pancreas breaks down and stops making insulin altogether. And you have just developed type 2 diabetes, insulin dependent. Now your body can't make insulin at all, or very, very limited amounts, and certainly not enough for insulin resistant cells. So now all this insulin is gone, all the blood sugar is still there, and now the cell isn't getting any sugar. Now the sugar is saying, hey, where did my sugar go? And now it starts making new receptors, it starts to upregulate the receptors, but it's too late, because there's no insulin to transport it across. And this is why diabetes is called starvation in the midst of plenty, because now you have all this food in the bloodstream, but none of it's getting into the cell. So the initial stage of diabetes, people will lose weight before they have figured out that they can't make insulin. All right? So the important thing to realize about this is that your body is magnificent. It's a healing machine. It's amazing. If it down-regulates something, it can up-regulate it again. So what has to happen to this picture? As long as you have some pancreas function left, you can salvage it, but you have to get rid of the insulin resistance. So what do you have to do? You have to balance your blood sugar. You have to get back to your hunter-gatherer diet and make sure that the insulin gets into the sugar gets into the bloodstream very, very gradually. And the second thing you have to do is exercise.